Oh, hey, is that the new Daughters album?
No. No.
Ah! Ah! Women! Self-titled!
Four-piece noise experimental rock group hailing all the way from Alberta, Canada, and this was their first debut full-length LP, self-titled Women, released in 2008. This is one of two records in the band's discography, the second of which being Public Strain, released in 2010. The band toured both of these records and then went on hiatus and subsequently broke up after the unfortunate tragic passing of guitarist and vocalist Christopher Raymer at the age of 26 in 2012. And what a debut record for a band this album was. With this album, they went on to cement their sound, which was a noisy and mathy take on rock music that would go on to inspire many in the next coming years. Bands such as Weather Day and Girl Band immediately come to mind, and it's amazing that we can derive all these massive bodies and noise and rock music just from four dudes jamming out recording on a boombox in their basement. And yes, many of the tracks on this record were recorded in just such a way. But the production of this record helps to perpetuate a sonic theme throughout the album of harsh twanging guitars and thumping rhythm and bass with washed out melancholy vocals in the background. And not to mention the dissonance on this record, because there is a lot of dissonance on this record. Speaking of dissonance, starting things off with the first track on the record, Cameras, we are immediately met with these harsh, dissonant, strung out vocals that just don't quite sound right. But the band quickly picks this up into a groove backed by drums and bass and a guitar that sounds more so like coins being rattled in a jar rather than a guitar being played. In terms of vocal delivery, Women have a very interesting take on vocal delivery on this record and the other record in their discography, that of which is being they don't have one particular vocalist. They do, but kind of everyone in the band chants along with that lead vocalist while he's saying what he's saying, and there's kind of this rotating cast of backup vocalists and who takes the lead at certain parts, which I love. It does make it difficult with crediting certain members of the band with their strange, dreamlike, vivid lyrics. For example, on this track, hang a garden hole, a curtain's home, shortened sleeves, they deform and have empty brains, open teeth. As this track picks up and comes to an end, noise synth is added, which helps it transition perfectly into the second track on the record, Lawn Care. We are met with this harsh, thumping eighth note kick drum backed by these guitars that are played and looped over top of each other at a disorienting pace, and frantic spoken word is splayed out as all of this goes on. As this song builds and gains some space, long vocal harmonies are sung out over top of all of this noise. Dissonance again is added to the mix. On top of all of this, this melancholic, beautiful, odd time, catchy, odd guitar line is played over top of it. The rest of the band latches onto this riff for the remainder of the song and builds it up into something beautiful, with vocals getting more intense, and it comes to a head when the guitar riff just turns into complete insanity and noise, and just this massive wall of synth noise and guitar and drums and bass is all just crashing against your headphones all at once. And I think the structure of this song represents what women try to do with a lot of tracks on this record. They start with something dissonant, harsh to the ear, something you don't like. They build it up, make the listener get used to that dissonance and that thing they don't like. And then they turn it into something beautiful. They completely flip it and then watch it just devolve as if it's this snowball rolling down a hill, gaining more and more snow just into this massive pile of noise. And the wall of noise at the end of the second track, Lawn Care, transitions it into Woodbine, the third track, which is arguably the most ambient, noisy track on the album. The visuals that I get in my head when I listen to this song, the droning loops of sleigh bells and hellish noises make me feel as though the devil himself is handing me a Christmas present or something like that. And this track's lack of structure and drone nature is a complete clash against the next track on the record, Black Rice. Which is arguably the most normal rock track on the record and really reminds me of some sort of weird like Velvet Underground B-side that I've never heard. And this track being near the center point of the album, it starts to gain more tangible concepts and themes. Things such as existentialism come up with the line, "That's what I like." Analyzing the lyrics through this song tells me a story, or rather an interpretation of what it's like to lose your composure and cool and fall into a depressive or manic state. As tension builds through the song in the second chorus, the vocalist sings out, "This to me says that the character of whoever is being talked about in this song wants something so bad that it physically feels as though he's fighting his way up a flight of stairs after it. In this case, the dazzling chain of a lover, or just as I interpret it, he's after love. But as the character begins to realize that his goal is unattainable, he loses his composure and begins to slip into that depressive state." This black rice, I believe, represents your composure. It's spilling and drifting apart. You're just watching it disintegrate practically before your eyes. But the band decides to go with a more folk inspiration path for the second half or remaining 14 minutes of this record. The next track I want to discuss, Group Transport Hall, signifies another swing in our character's mood. But this time it's back into optimism with the line, "Soon we will be laughing out there on the landing." But this moment is quickly subsided by another harsh hit of reality with the line, "Dancing through the ash, you made other plans. Soon we'll start to pick up on the feud." The idea of ash representing depression or something you have to wade through in life is consistent throughout the album and gets mentioned a couple of times. And I think the way that this record is structured and the songs within it can speak to life as a whole. It's this constant up and down or a roller coaster of emotion going from positive to negative. And in life, nothing is going to stay positive or negative forever. It's going to be constantly swaying back and forth looking for balance. Although the ash, as they put it on the record, will always come back and cover up what you have built up. This concept and idea is what I believe my personal favorite track on the record, Shaking Hand, to be about. We are immediately met with this harsh, dissonant, odd rhythm guitar line that is quickly picked up by the other members of the band, with another guitar, bass, and drums working perfectly in tandem with it. The song then goes through a few progressions, each with a time signature of their own, making it a little difficult to find the downbeat in particular. And the song eventually returns to its beginning riff with each member of the band chanting out. I think this is a symbol of time and time past. As I mentioned before, I think our character is thinking about the past, and I think these bloody watches represent that. We are then hit with this beautiful positive progression of double arpeggiated guitars and drum and bass, and this rhythm is quickly built up into double time in one of the most spectacular fashions I've ever heard in a song. As the song reaches its climax, we are hit with this beautiful burst of tremendous guitar chords and double lead runs that begins very abrasive and loud, but then quickly quiets down as the song just comes to a close. Things such as hinting at substance abuse are brought up in the next track, Upstairs, with the line, "Stripping senses nightly, undecided, all of your blues are just passing through." This song in the second half devolves into a thumping bass line backed by a guitar playing the same chord over and over again, with what sounds like circus hell music being played in the background, and perhaps a violin being brutally murdered in the corner of the room. And after this buildup, the tension is released, and our story on this record comes to that of a totally insane, nonsensical person. The track January 8th is characterized by this constant increase in tempo over the first three quarters of the song, eventually coming to a head with thumping kick drums, loud twanging guitars, driving constantly just down, 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 as one of our lead singers says, "I see the light most of the time." And this is before the record breaks into the absolute insanity that is the final track, Flashlights. This track has practically no structure and almost makes me feel as though it was an improv song added to this record. It's characterized by this walking, modulating, constantly changing bass line, and the bassist sounds as though he couldn't care less whether or not he's playing the right notes. With a noise guitar being played on top of it, once again, one chord, with distortion just constantly being thrown on top and taken off and thrown on top again, blasting out the front of that speaker and that amp. And then all at once, all of the members break out into tandem of what could be considered a rhythm bass line, but kind of sounds like the strap in your seatbelt sign on an airplane. The constant ding, 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 ding. And as more guitars are added on top of this, it sounds like shrapnel's flying by my head. This song is honestly probably as close as you can get to being in a plane crash without actually being in a plane crash. It is a very abrasive yet natural ending to this record, and I think that is a saying that could sum this record up almost perfectly. It's very abrasive yet natural somehow, and feels as though it's very familiar to the listener. And with a record as influential as this one and as amazing as this one, I honestly would feel terrible with myself giving it nothing other than a 10 out of 10. I hope you enjoyed my review of this record. Please go check it out for yourself, give it a listen, and let me know what you think.
I'm just gonna, reckless abandon.
Yeah.
Fucking safety.
All right. Okay, so it's recording. It looks like it's in frame. You ready?
Oh, no.
No. Oh, my God.
Hey, it's fine. I thought it was gonna leak way more.
Honey, dude.